Hello, I'm Dr. Rajitha. Welcome to Anatomy Channel. Today we shall study about fourth ventricle, which is the cavity of hindbrain. And fourth ventricle is present within the posterior cranial fossa. Posteriorly, it is related to the cerebellum, and anteriorly, it is related to the pons and open part of medulla oblongata. And fourth ventricle communicates above with the cerebral aqueduct, and below it continues as the central canal of medulla oblongata. And in sagittal section, the fourth ventricle appears to be like a triangular in cut section, and in horizontal section it appears to be like a rhomboid in shape. And the fourth ventricle features can be studied under recesses, angles, boundaries. First, coming to the recesses. Recesses are the extensions of the fourth ventricle, and these recesses are, one is dorsomedial recess, which extends into the core of the cerebellum along its roof, and the other two are the two lateral recesses. These two lateral recesses extends laterally till cerebellopontine angle, near till the inferior cerebellar peduncle on the either side, and these lateral recesses opens up into the subarachnoid space. The openings are called as foramen of Lushka. And there are two dorsolateral recesses also, which are related near the inferior medullary vellum, which are the blind recesses present in the fourth ventricle. Coming to the angles are superior angle, inferior angle, and two lateral angles. Superior angle continues as cerebral aqueduct, inferior angle continues as the central canal, and two lateral angles opens up as an apertures called as foramen of Lushka. Next, we shall see about the boundaries of fourth ventricle. The boundaries of fourth ventricle, we shall start with the roof. The roof is formed by superior medullary vellum and inferior medullary vellum. These are the sloping surfaces of the roof, which are separated by dorsomedial recess. Superior medullary vellum separates the lingula from the fourth ventricle, which is made up of white matter and which converges the two superior cerebellar peduncles. So the bridges between the two superior cerebellar peduncles, separating it from the lingula of cerebellum, which is a part of vermis of cerebellum. Next, about the inferior medullary vellum. Inferior medullary vellum is a non-nervous sheet where it is lined by the ependyma and it is covered by a double-layered fold of pia mater. This double-layered fold of pia mater is called as tela choroidae. Tela choroidae consists of blood vessels which are called as choroid plexus. The choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle, which enters along the roof inferior medullary vellum and within the double layered pia mater, and these choroid plexus are derived from posterior inferior cerebellar arteries. And if you see the choroid plexus, it appears to be like a letter T with having a horizontal limb and two vertical fringes, and these vertical fringes are interrupted by foramen of Magendie. Foramen of Magendie is the communication along the inferior medullary vellum dorsally, where it communicates with to a large space which is called as cerebellomedullary cistern or cisterna magna, where the ventricular system communicates with the subarachnoid space. There are five openings in the fourth ventricle. One is the cerebral aqueduct, the opening to the cerebral aqueduct of the midbrain, and below the central canal of the spinal cord, and inferiorly, dorsomedially, foramen of Magendie, and on the either side foramen of Lushka. Let's see the features of floor of fourth ventricle. Floor of fourth ventricle appears to be like a rhomboid depression, so it is also called as rhomboid fossa. It has got two superolateral boundaries formed by superior cerebellar peduncles and two inferolateral boundaries formed by the inferior cerebellar peduncle. Superior cerebellar peduncle connects the midbrain with the cerebellum, and inferior cerebellar peduncle connects the medulla with the cerebellum. And the floor of fourth ventricle is divided into three parts, the upper triangular part, which is formed by the dorsal surface of pons, and lower triangular part, which is formed by the open dorsal part of medulla oblongata, and the intermediate part, which is formed by the dorsal part of pontomedullary junction. And the intermediate part is identified by faint striae, which are like faint fibers, called as striales, are the fibers which are arising from the accessory cuneate nucleus of medulla, and these fibers are called as external arcuate fibers. So these posterior external arcuate fibers runs on the either side towards the cerebellum. And the floor of fourth ventricle can be divided into two halves by means of a median sulcus. And the median sulcus, lateral to the median sulcus, the eminence on the either side is called as medial eminence. Medial eminence is again separated from the lateral part by means of a faint sulcus, which is called as sulcus limitans. And over the medial eminence, there are two oval elevations present in the upper posterior part of the pons called as facial colliculi. And these facial colliculi are formed by facial nerve, deep to which the nucleus is abducens nucleus or sixth cranial nerve nucleus. So the motor fibers of the facial nerve winds round the abducens nucleus, forming an internal genu. This internal genu shown as an elevated part called as facial colliculus. And tracing the sulcus limitans, above it ends by means of a small triangular depression, which is called as superior fovea. Just medial and superior to the superior fovea, there is a bluish colored pigmented area called as locus cerealis. Locus cerealis is also called substantia ferrugina, and it consists of nerves which produces more of norepinephrine and noradrenaline as neurotransmitters. And coming to the lower end of the sulcus limitans, the lower end ends by means of inferior fovea, which is also a depression seen in the lower part of the fourth ventricle. And further, the sulcus limitans runs as an oblique line, dividing the inferior part into medial one triangle called as hypoglossal triangle, and below the triangle is called as the vagal triangle. Hypoglossal nuclei are present and nucleus intercalatus are present deep to hypoglossal triangle, and vagal triangle, nucleus ambiguous, dorsal nucleus of vagus are present deep to the vagal triangle. And the lateral area, which is common between the pons and medulla, is called as vestibular area because vestibular nuclei are present deep. And the lower end, near the lower tip of the fourth ventricle, the vagal triangle is separated from area called as area prostema. The thin fiber-like supparens is called as funiculus supparens. Area postrema is considered as the vomiting center because it consists of chemo-trigger zone receptors. And this is a neuroglial tissue which is highly vascular, and there is no blood-brain barrier. And any stimulation to the chemo-trigger zone receptors will cause vomiting. And the lower tip, where the tinea are converging, forming the roof of the lower inferior angle, is called as the obex. On the either side of the area prostrema, gracile tubercle is present, and laterally the inferior part is bounded by the cuneate tubercle, and lateral most is formed by the inferior cerebellar peduncle. Here is the sagittal section of the brain to show the location of fourth ventricle. The fourth ventricle is present within the hindbrain, the cavity present in the hindbrain, in front of cerebellum and behind the pons and medulla oblongata. This small triangular tent-shaped cavity is the fourth ventricle. This is the closer view to show the roof of the fourth ventricle in sagittal section. And this is the cerebellum, and this is the dorsal surface of pons, and 3 is the medulla oblongata. The upper part of the roof is formed by superior medullary vellum, which is formed by the white matter of brain, which is separating it from the lingula. And inferior medullary vellum is formed by 5 and 4 numbers here, which are formed by the ependyma and tela choroidae, which is the double layered biomatter containing choroid plexus. Here the specimen, the cerebellar hemispheres are cut along the vermis to show the cavity of the fourth ventricle along with its boundaries and the floor. And superiorly we can see the midbrain is present. The boundaries of the floor of fourth ventricle, superolaterally it is bounded by superior cerebellar peduncles. Inferolaterally it is bounded by inferior cerebellar peduncles on the either side. And down we can see the central canal of medulla continuing down near the apex. And here on the either side is by middle cerebellar peduncle. Features in the floor, the median sulcus divides the floor into two halves. And in the upper part of the floor, we can see the facial colliculus, which is a round elevation present in the upper half of the floor formed on the dorsal side of the pons. And inferiorly, we can see the hypoglossal triangle medially. This area is the hypoglossal triangle. Below is the vagal trigone or vagal triangle. And the tip is called obex. Lateral to the obex is the gracile tubercle, and little more lateral is the cuneate tubercle. And the lateral area which is common between the pons and medulla is the vestibular area. Here the pinned spotter is identified as facial colliculus, which is seen in the upper part of the fourth ventricle. And it is formed by the facial nerve, and nucleus deep to the facial colliculus is abducens nucleus. So many vital centers are present in the floor of fourth ventricle. That is the reason and studying the anatomy of floor of fourth ventricle is very essential. Thank you. I hope you like my session. Please like, share, subscribe and press the bell button for further notifications. Bye.